Hi, I am Yusuke Noda from Japan, and I'm going to talk about the effects of laparoscopic origami training, the training of making origami cranes. As all doctors know, laparoscopic surgery is technically challenging. To master this surgical procedure, we need a lot of experience. For an example, for laparoscopic nephrectomy, there is a study that showed that operative duration shortens after a doctor experienced 100 or more cases. For the benefit of the patient, we have to try to shorten the learning phase. This is why training for laparoscopic surgery is important. To understand the procedure, doctors read books and watch videos, but in this presentation, I will show the usefulness of training using training boxes. Origami is a Japanese traditional art of paper folding. We set up a training box in a standard manner and use 7.5 centimeters squared origami to make more than 2,000 origami cranes. We use Cuvillian Maryland ligature forceps on the right hand and the Amco Microline Renew forceps on the left hand. We held the paper with one hand and fold it with the other. This process is an exercise for increasing coordination between both hands. Making a paper crane requires movements similar to grasping, dissection, and pushing with proper force. This process improves depth perception and may result in better movement for the forceps. As we go on, the paper gets thicker and the procedure becomes more difficult. Shaping the beak is the most difficult part because it requires close coordination between both hands. Finally, we spread the wings and finish. This figure shows the time that a resident needed to make paper cranes. This resident initially had no experience with laparoscopic surgeries. In the beginning, about an hour was required. However, after experiencing 100 cases, the average time shortened to 10 minutes. This is my own record. I didn't measure the time I needed to create my first crane, so this is not a complete record. But roughly speaking, I needed 8 minutes to make 200 paper cranes, and my best time was 3 minutes and 24 seconds in case number 1285. The good thing with this training is that we can notice our own improvements in the operation skills. The more you train, the shape of the paper crane gets better. These are the key techniques in laparoscopic surgery. Understanding the pivot point of the trocar, insertion and withdrawal movements, pitch and yaw, roll and grip, and stereoscopic vision. This training naturally gives you these skills you need to perform laparoscopic procedures. And this training enables us to develop these hand-eye coordination skills. We can improve the surgeon's ability to grasp, dissect, and push tissues using the proper force by enhancing tactile sensation. These skills cannot be improved with standard suturing training. Now we will show how this training improves surgeons' performance in real laparoscopic surgeries. This figure shows the pneumoperitoneum time of laparoscopic nephrectomy and nephroureterectomy. Before the first case, I made about 100 cranes. Besides that, I had no experience with laparoscopic surgeries. Even from the first case, you can see that the operation had been stable. There were no operator changes, blood transfusions, or serious perioperative complications. The average pneumoperitoneum time was 110 minutes. We applied the cumulative sum analysis to this data. No learning curve was observed on the pneumoperitoneum time. Let me conclude. The origami training is easy to start. Its running cost is low, and it's easy to keep the motivation. I recommend the origami training to general doctors who want to practice laparoscopic surgeries. I've uploaded several videos about this training to YouTube. If you are interested, please search them by laparoscopic origami training. Thank you for watching this video.